Well, he's one of the hardest men of rugby league, but nothing could prepare Robbie Farah for a vile and unexpected cheap shot.
It was a social media attack on his recently deceased mother, the second celebrity internet assault in a fortnight, and that is finally forcing authorities to act. Here's Christian De Garis.
Robbie Farah's mum was his biggest fan. He's still grieving her death after she passed away in June. It makes last night's tweet of deeply offensive remarks about her all the more sickening.
It shook me up and, mate, I was absolutely disgusted.
The West Tigers captain tweeted the Prime Minister and New South Wales Premier demanding new laws, saying people need to be accountable for their comments.
It's going to get to a point one day where someone's going to really hurt themselves over some comments that people make, and I'd hate to see that happen, so I think something needs to be done about it now.
Barry O'Farrell quickly responded, saying he would follow it up with the federal police.
We are seeking a review of existing Commonwealth legislation to see what between the Commonwealth and the states we can do to close any potential loopholes that exist.
But there are already Commonwealth laws making it an offence to use the internet to menace, harass or offend, with prison terms of up to 10 years. Experts say police simply need to enforce them.
But this is becoming a serious problem, and they can find who is posting this kind of offensive material.
Today, the federal police passed the responsibility back to the states, but the New South Wales police say its cybercrime unit is focused on catching pedophiles and fraud. With state and federal governments passing the buck, experts say the most effective way to stop troll behaviour is with an industry-developed code of conduct. But they accept that scenario is pretty unlikely. Christian De Garis, 10 News.